Hi, Star Babies. Welcome to, you guessed it, another episode of Cosmic Chemistry. It's my little YouTube show where I talk about love and romance, chemistry, dating, crushes, anything you want to know within the love realm of zodiac signs and astrology. And I like to play with my little wigs to get into character of my little love guru identity. So I'm going to go into the comments from my last Cosmic Chemistry. Thank you guys so much. We have 85 comments. Thank you so much for watching. And I'm just going to randomly pick some. What I did was I chose 4 random comments from my last Cosmic Chemistry video that you guys requested for pairings. And I'm going to talk about them today. And so I just kind of fire off my general first impressions. And this is just kind of my general impression for people who want to know. So, Aries and Libra. So, when I think of fire and air, Aries is a fire sign and Libra is an air sign. And I usually think that those are just wonderful pairings. Those are the impressions I get when I see air and fire signs together. My boyfriend and I are an air and fire sign together. And I think that Libra and Aries are a fantastic couple. I think that Aries can lean on the unpredictable side and on the side of kind of rash decisions, snap decisions. They might be a little hot-headed. And Libras don't like to rock the boat when it's not necessary. And they are very, very patient. They are good at weighing options, seeing both sides. So I think with a hot-headed Aries, if they start, you know, some kind of argument, a Libra would be able to maybe see their point of view.
Look at the little boo-boo. He is such a little brat. Cause he just wants all the attention when I'm filming. Yes, you do. Yes.
Yeah, I think they're a great couple. I think they can definitely light each other up. I think that when I think of fire and air signs, I think air feeds the flames. They feed that beautiful chemical energy, and the chemistry just builds, you know, because you add oxygen to flame and it increases in size and power. So I think that a Libra can offer a great, fun, humorous companion for an Aries without adding to their drama for the most part. For the most part, Libras aren't just, you know, scream and shout, overreaction, dramatic type of people. They usually don't like to hold on to grudges for too long, which is kind of the same thing with Aries. Aries is kind of like they say their piece, they have their moment, and then they're moving on. You know, Aries and Libra are both fast-moving people. I think as long as they learn healthy communication, they are totally an awesome couple. And yeah, I think most air and fire signs together are just total awesome chemistry. Cancer man and Virgo man. I also think that earth and water signs tend to be totally fantastic. I have no idea what ringing is going on outside. I'm so sorry if you can hear that. Seriously, what is that? There we go. Okay. Cancer and Taurus for me is always like this magic pair that I keep seeing. But Cancer and Virgo can be similar. I think Virgo men are very gentlemanly. They are very polite. They are very Prince Charming. I don't know. They just kind of do everything right in the sense of chivalry and being kind and considerate and patient. And in that sense, I think they work very well with Cancer because they are not abrasive, usually. Virgo men can be a little bit cocky, but not in an obnoxious way, not like usually body cocky or like big juice head beefy guys. They're more like intellectually cocky or like, I know better than you, but I think the right kind of Cancer could kind of put that person in check. I think they have a lot to offer one another. I think Virgo can offer Cancer grounding that they might need, and maybe a more, I guess, like, logical way of looking at things. So, you know, being with a Virgo man could teach you about planning and goal setting and kind of realistic, concrete things. You know, they might even be able to help you in your business or your career. And, you know, in the reverse, being with a Cancer as a Virgo man would open you more to your emotions, open you more to discussions about your emotions, and open you up to things that you can't always control, letting your control go a little bit. Because Cancers are pretty good at letting control go sometimes if they're healthy. You know, they cry when they need to cry. They laugh when they want to laugh. They feel what they need to feel. They are these open receptacles. Is that the right word? It kind of sounds like a garbage can, but open receptacles for all of the world and universe's emotions. And that can be really special when you're someone who might take life a little too seriously sometimes. And with the two men together, I think that's a great energy. I feel like it's really good. I feel like Virgo men are really the Prince Charming, and Cancer men especially can be very, very seductive and just intense and lovely. And so I think those two signs together would be totally great. I think with the traditional masculine-masculine combination, it actually might be more tolerable to be with a Virgo man as a man. Because for me, you know, if I were with a Virgo man, when men offer me advice or kind of talk like they know better, there's this other, like, facet where I'm kind of like, are you doing this because I'm a woman? It's not because you know better, whatever, whatever. Are you doing this because I'm a woman? Or the same thing if you're with someone who's older than you and talks to you like that. Instead of trying to really improve your life, you could feel like, are you ageist? Like, do you think that I'm stupid because I'm younger than you? So Cancer man and Virgo man, I think, is a really bomb couple. Pisces man and Taurus woman. So it's another water and earth sign, which I always think are fantastic. I think Taurians especially are just so good at taking those signs that me as a fire sign can't always handle, you know, that the intense emotions, the mood swings that are possibly there, just certain aspects that maybe I don't understand because I don't have a lot of water in my chart. Because you know what, the moon was in Cancer recently and I was an emotional mess. I was weeping every 10 minutes. I was feeling all of the feelings and I just thought to myself several times, I get it. But what I think is so special about Taurians is they are so down to earth, yet they are deeply emotional within that. So they're not like emotionally closed off, they're not emotionless, they're much more to me traditionally more emotional, empathetic than say a Capricorn. And they are much more emotional than an Aquarius. A Taurian is like a great combination of the sturdiness of the spirit of earth signs and also the emotion and kind of the gentle sensuality of water signs. They are kind of like a mix to me. So a Pisces man and a Taurus woman, I think this is a great couple. We have some bomb couples right here. Pisces men tend to have... Pisces women, I find, love to have that like, oh my god, like, ah, like my life isn't together. Like, they're kind of sarcastic and funny in that way. They love being like, ugh, like I'm a mess. I'm a literal mess. Like, ugh, I'm wacky. And when they kind of are like messes, they can be like super, like, you need to actually get your shit together. Pisces men are less of that, like, I'm a mess. Ooh, I'm so wacky. And they're more like... they're more playful, childish, impish to me, and just dreamy people. And, you know, as I always say, slippery fish, hard to catch. I think that a Taurus woman could really ground a Pisces man, but also embrace all of the emotion and all of the passion and love that he has to give, because Taurians, especially Taurus women, love to be showered with love and affection. They love it. They love to be worshipped as the goddesses they are. And I think a Pisces man could give the Taurus woman a little bit more go with the flow energy in her life, a little bit more spontaneity, a little bit more let's try this. Who cares if we fail? Who cares if we look stupid? Taurians and earth signs in general can really, really, really get into habits a lot. It takes somebody special to really break them out of those habits and for them to be able to have a good time. So I think a Pisces man could tap into those very poetic, romantic aspects of a Taurus that she might not always tap into on the daily because she's so focused on her work, her life. She's so driven. She's so here on earth. And I do find, though, that Taurians are really charmed by poetry. They're charmed by beauty and romance and being wooed and being courted. And I think Pisces men are like... Pisces men remind me of, like, what a sexy little minstrel would be back in the medieval days. Like, a sexy guy who plays his lute for you and sings you poetry he wrote about you. And the Taurus is just... the maiden basking in the sun with flowers in her hair. I think it's a very, very romantic and lovely couple. So, good luck with y'all. And last but not least, Scorpio and Leo. We have a major, major, I guess, power couple. We have a force to be reckoned with this couple. I have been with a Scorpio, and it was my first serious relationship, and that dynamic is absolutely... magical. Anytime, I mean, you rarely meet like a Scorpio with a Leo, honestly. And I don't know if they are long-lasting relationships. I guess I will never know because I'm not with that Scorpio anymore. But I mean, depending on also where you are in your lives and your trust levels, that's gonna change things. You know, if you're a Leo who's at a stage where she's jealous and insecure, jaded by past relationships, it might not be so pretty. And same with a Scorpio. If he, she, or they are distrustful, overly possessive, you know, there are very, very dark sides to both signs that if they come out, it can be a very toxic and terrible relationship. They're both actually quite narcissistic signs when it comes down to it, and that's okay. I mean, thinking of yourself first is not a problem to me, and it's not, I mean, maybe that's because I'm a Leo, but it's not a bad thing. But when you are constantly seeking the other person to please you and kind of don't want the other person to have their own life outside of you, Leo and Scorpio can be like that. However, if you're healthy, if you're at a good place in your life, if you guys are both, you know, mentally stable and emotionally healthy, I think it can be a completely electric relationship. I do, because I think Leos love to be with interesting people, with people with sex appeal, people with who just walk into a room and you notice them. But Scorpios are not that obnoxious, notice me energy that Leos can be. So it's a great dynamic because the Leo loves that the Scorpio gets this attention, the Scorpio charms other people. That's very attractive to me as a Leo. When other people find my partner attractive, I don't care. Like, he's not gonna entertain those girls, but the fact that they think that he's attractive is like, yes, he is. Like, I love having the best, I mean, if we're gonna use like a lion terminology and reduce my boyfriend to a piece of meat, you know, I love having the best slice of meat from the gazelle, said the vegan. That's how I am, you know? I like a little bit of like, yeah, I have the best in life, including the best partner. You wish. and I think the Scorpio admires the Leo's ability to be out on stage. The world is a stage. They're pretty much an open book. And I really think Scorpios can rarely be like that with everybody. You know, they're not showy. They don't want to show the innermost sides of them. They're not obnoxious thespians, you know what I mean? And I think Scorpios can sometimes find that really exciting and really attractive about Leos. That they're just dramatic, they're just 100% themselves, they seem to be effortless in everything they do, which we all know they're not. Yeah, I always am wary, however, of a Scorpio or water sign in general's tendency to be possessive, but especially Scorpio. Leos love for people to admire them. We love for people to notice us, for people to hit on us and flirt with us, and we love to be an object in high demand. So doesn't really make sense to them sometimes, I feel like, and it could get on their nerves. Like, why can't I be enough for you? Why do you need validation from others? But it's like, it's not the same kind of love. It just, we live for the applause, applause. Just be wary of Scorpio's possessiveness. And Scorpio, if you are looking for a Leo or you like the Leo, be wary of if you know you have an issue with people who need a lot of validation from other people, you know? As much as they might be sexy to you, if you are going after a Leo who has thousands of followers on Instagram and is loving social media and is a social butterfly and just loves to be the star of the party, and you secretly kind of resent people that are like that, stay away, because you're going to end up dulling their flame with your water. You're going to be dumping water on their vivacious flame, and they're going to end up resenting you for doing that. So, coming from experience, I've had both sides. You know, there was for sure this element of like me feeling a little bit held back or like I couldn't really sparkle, because especially when a Scorpio is sad or upset, they kind of want you, like, misery loves company, you know? They want you to share in their misery, and if you're super happy when they're super sad, it pisses them off. So just be wary of that. But honestly, if the chemistry's there, go for it, because that is a gorgeous relationship. And that wraps up this episode of Cosmic Chemistry. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope I helped you out. Yeah, this was a blast, guys. Have an amazing week wherever you are, and you are enough. That's my message for this video. You're enough. I love you guys so much, and talk to you soon. Mwah. Bye, guys.